أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاة. حي على الصلاة. حي على الفلاح. حي على الفلاح.
إن الحمد لله، نحمدك ربي ونستعينك ونستغفرك ونتوب إليك ونثني عليك الخير كله، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. والحمد لله الذي أمر بالبر والإحسان، والحمد لله الذي نهى عن العقوق وأذي الإنسان، والحمد لله الذي هدانا وأعطانا وكفانا، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له شهادة نرجو بها الفوز والعفو والغفران، وأشهد أن حبيبنا ونبينا وسيدنا وقائدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم عبده ورسوله الذي أمرنا بالبر وعن العقوق نهانا، صلوات الله عليه وعلى آله وصحابته الذين كانوا للحق وعلى فعل الخير عنوانا. أحبتي في الله، أوصيكم وإياي بتقوى الله سبحانه وتعالى، فاتقوه واطيعوه وراقبوه ولا تعصوه، واتقوا يوما ترجعون فيه إلى الله، يوم لا ينفع مال ولا بنون إلا من أتى الله بقلب سليم. All praises and thanks are due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To Him and Him alone belong all the praises and thanks. We praise Him and we thank him, and we seek his forgiveness, and we ask him for his mercy. And none has the right to be worshipped except him, Allah. And that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his servant and last messenger. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, I advise myself and you to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as he should be feared, and to die as a true Muslim believer. Ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu anhu قال سألت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم عن أحب الأعمال إلى الله فقلت يا رسول الله أي العمل أحب إلى الله؟ فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم الصلاة بوقتها أو الصلاة على وقتها. فقلت ثم أي يا رسول الله؟ فقال بر الوالدين. فقلت ثم أي يا رسول الله؟ قال الجهاد في سبيل الله. Ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu anhu, he said, I have asked the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves from his servant. The most beloved deed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replied by saying, number one, as-salatu ala waqtiha, the prayers on time. Then I have asked the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what is the second most beloved deed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Said, birrul walidain, kindness to the parents, or righteousness to the parents. And then Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam told me the third deed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, al jihadu fi sabilillah. And today's subject, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, and birr al-walidain. After worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ala al-ibad, haqqu Allah ala al-ibad, an ya'buduh, wa la yushriku bihi shay'a, wa bil walidain ihsana. The right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on his servants to worship him alone, and not to associate other God beside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then haqq al-ibad, the right of the human beings on us, birru al-walidain, to be righteous, to be kind to your parents. And that's what we're here for today, to remind myself first, then remind you, because us as a human beings, we're busy in dunya. Dunya occupies us so much, and then you forgot about the two old men. The old man and old woman in your house, well, you forgot about them. You've been distracted with your wealth, with your children, with your work, with your wife, and you forgot about your mother or your father. The right's on us. When Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a man came to him and he told him, oh Rasulullah, who deserves my fine treatment? If I have 1 hour to give, who should I give it to? Who should I spend this time with? I have so much friend around me. Who should I take my best friend? If I have some wealth to spend on, who should I spend it on? He said, your mother. And your mother. And your mother, then your father. The mother's status more than the father, because the mother who carried you in her stomach for 9 months, went through the pain and suffering, and then she delivered you. She went through that pain again. Then she breastfed you to see you as a grown man. And the father worked a long time to see you as a grown up. Now it's time to pay back. Another man came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, O Rasulullah, أُرِيدُ الْجِهَادُ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. O Rasulullah, I would love to go make jihad in the sake of Allah, to give nusra to this deen. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what do you think he asked him the first question? How strong you are. How will you train to fight in the battlefield? La la wallah. He asked him, any of your parents are still alive? قال نعم يا رسول الله كلاهما. Both of them are still alive. He said, اذهب فجاهد فيهما. Go and be obedient to them. You want al-Jannah? This man came from Bilad al-Yemen. He said, you want Jannah? Jannah's in your hometown. And you want to fight in the sake of Allah? Go be obedient to them. How about us today, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam? Are you obedient to your parents? Umar radiallahu anhu in his time, an old man walking in the Medina, leaning on his cane, his back is bent, losing his sight. For what? He missed his son, who was fighting jihad fi sabilillah. He was making poetry in the streets of Al-Madina, missing his son so much. And the news came to Umar radiallahu anhu, so they brought him in. And he told him, what is the matter with you? What are your story? He said, oh Amir al-Mu'mineen, my son in the battlefield, fighting in the sake of Allah. But he left me and his mother old, no one to take care of us. Then Umar al-Khattab radiallahu anhu brought this man from the battlefield. He said, come here. What are you doing so special to your father? He's missing you so much. He said, oh Amir al-Mu'mineen, I'm very obedient to my parents so much. Besides that, I go at night, early in the morning, and milk the camels. And I go find the best milk for my father and mother. And I get so much, and I get it cooled down for them, and I wait beside their bed. Soon as they wake up, I serve them this fresh milk. Every morning I do that. Besides being obedient to them, he told him, go ahead, bring some fresh milk. So Amir al-Mu'mineen asking this man, هل لك من حاجة? Any wishes would you like? He said, نعم, يا أمير المؤمنين. أود أن أرى ابني لمرة واحدة وأشمه شمة واحدة وأضمه ضمة واحدة قبل أن أموت. My wish to hug my son and squeeze him and get a good smell of him before I die. This is my wish. Then Amir al-Mu'mineen brought him this milk and he told him, drink this milk. Then he carried this milk and he started crying again. He said, what's now? He said, Wallahi ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, I know my son is far away in the battlefield. قال والله إني أشم رائحة ابني في هذا اللبن. But I swear I can smell the hands of my son through this milk. He told him, this is your son. And he commanded the son to go be obedient to the father and mother. This is jihad في سبيل الله. When Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم and his Sahaba passed by a strong man, he's working in the field. They said, oh Rasulullah, look at this strong man. We wish we had him fighting with us, jihad fi sabilillah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, this work he's doing, this is jihad fi sabilillah. This is mujahada. This man is working day and night to support his family and be obedient to his father and mother. This is jihad fi sabilillah also. Be obedient to your father and to your mother at all the times. Uwais ibn Amir had an old mother. She was also blind. In the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was stationed in Yemen. And then he said, I want to go and visit Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Al-Madinah. But it takes me to travel months to get to Al-Madinah. But who will take care of my mother? My old mother, she's blind. And no one can take care of my mother like I do. He gave up the position to become a Sahabi, to become a Tabi'i. For what? For the sake of his mother. This man took care of his mother. No one knew about him but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knew his status. Jibreel alayhi salam informed Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there is a man who's taking care of his mother. Be obedient. So before the death of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Umar, he told him there's a man who takes care of his mother. If he comes visit you, oh Umar, make him make a dua for you. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not see this man. So this man, whenever his mother passed away, he traveled to Al-Madinah. And he met with Umar radiallahu anhu. Umar radiallahu anhu, he told him that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam informed him his status. And he asked him to make a dua. A sahabi wants a dua from a tabi'i. To the status. Why? Because this man, his dua is mustajab. Due to the righteousness of his mother, his dua is mustajab. لو أقسم على الله لا أبره. Whenever he lifts his hand up, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his dua is answered automatically. Due to the righteousness of his mother. أبا هريرة رضي الله عنه إذ نادته أمه يوما فقالت يا أبا هريرة يا أبا هريرة فأجابها قائلا لبيك يا أمه لبيك يا أمه فشعر أبا هريرة أن صوته أرفع من صوت أمه فذهب يستغفر الله سبحانه وتعالى من هذه المعصية. Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, once his mother called him. And he replied back by saying, Labbaik ya umma, O mother, I am at your service. But he felt the tone of his voice is higher than his mother's voice. So what did he do? He went to make istighfar. He went to make tawbah from hadhihi al-ma'asiyah. He thought it was a sin he has committed, a sin. ومن هذا أبا هريرة رضي الله عنه. Whenever he leaves his house, he stands by the footsteps of the door. He tell her, السلام عليك يا أمة ورحمة الله وبركاته. فتقول له وعليك السلام يا ولدي ورحمة الله وبركاته. And then he tells her, oh my mother, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you and have mercy on you, just like he raised me when I was young. Then she replies back and she said, oh my son, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with you and have mercy on you, because too you are righteous to me. Every time he leaves that house, he told her these beautiful words. And she replies by these beautiful words. وهذا ابن عباس رضي الله عنه, the famous companion of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. They told him, ابن عباس, بر الوالدين is so huge. Righteousness toward the parents are huge. Too many to mention. فماذا عقوق الوالدين? What is the disobedience to the parents considered? He said, إن الولد إذا نفض ثوبه فتطاير الغبار على أبيه أو أمه فكتب عند الله عاقا. He told them an example. If the son or the daughter has a thawb, piece of cloth, contains dust, And then he shook this piece of cloth. If the dust goes to the father or the mother, he will be written as عاق, as a disobedient. Imagine. I want to ask you a question. If Abu Hurairah رضي الله عنه and Ibn Abbas رضي الله عنه living in our houses today, and here, how's the daughter or the son responds to their father or their mother, even 5 or 6 years old, how they respond? فَلَا تَقُلْ لَهُنَا أُفٍّ وَلَا تَنْهَرْهُنَا. Ibn Abbas رضي الله عنه said, if anything was mentioned in the Quran, if there's a word less than uff, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will mention it in the Quran. Not shouting at them, not to become a disobedient to them. Months ago, we did a call in the middle of the night. The mother is complaining about her son. How come? Not just shouting or being disobedient, but he abuses, physical abuse to the mother. How come? Because she won't give him no money to go ahead and get some drugs. He beats her up on daily basis, he bruises her. Imagine. And this is the signs of the day of judgment. The son disobeys the father or the mother. And he be kind to his friendship. When it comes to his father and mother, he becomes so disobedient. Or the son, he'll be so kind to his wife and he disobeys his mother. These are the signs of the day of judgment, just like what's happening today. وكيف حالنا اليوم؟ لا يدخل الجنة عاق. The disobedient person shall not enter paradise. And whenever we mention this hadith, that means he will be delayed from entering Jannah. ولا يشم رائحة الجنة ولا يكلمه الله ولا ينظر إليه ولا يزكيه العاق. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not look at him on the day of judgment, and he will not purify him, and shall not speak to him, and he will not smell the smell of paradise. Imagine. Hassan al-Basri, when his mother died, he cried so much. They told him, Ya Aba Sa'id, Inna al-Mawtu Haqq. Death is truth, and you're crying because you lost your mother. Qala adri. Qala wa kayfa la abki. Wa qad ughliqa alayya al-yawm babun min abwab al-jannah. He said, yes, I know, death is true. But today, one of the gates of paradise has been closed. Your father and your mother, two gates of paradise. من أمسى وأصبح مرضيا لوالديه كان له بابان من الجنة مفتوحان. Whoever pleased with his father, mother, being obedient to them in the evening and in the morning, two gates of paradise will be open for you. Every single day, you are obedient to your parents, two doors of paradise will be open for you. And the one who's a disobedient to his parents, two gates of hellfire will be open for you. Every single day you disobey them, two doors of hellfire will be open for you. You choose. What do you want? In this dunya, the most beloved thing we need to live a long time and have lots of wealth. This is our wish. If you want that to happen to you, be obedient to your parents. فَلْيَسِلَ رَحِمَةً أَوْ يَبِرُّ وَالِدَيْهِ. To be righteous to your parents and visit your kinship. If you want to live a long time, and have lots of wealth. Now the second part, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, this is the rights of the parents. Now the rights of the children on us. قال ابن القيم رحمه الله إن الوالد يسأل عن ولده يوم القيامة قبل أن يسأل الولد عن والده. The father will be asked about the son on the day of judgment before the son will be asked about the father. How did you raise him up? What kind of youngship he had? In the time of Umar radiallahu anhu, a man came complaining regarding his son. His son is disobedient. So Umar radiallahu anhu, he told him, bring your son. And Umar radiallahu anhu, when I punished the young son, he told him, oh Amir al-Mu'mineen, let me tell you my story first. I also have rights on my father. He told him, yes, go ahead. He said, my father, well, when I was born, he gave one of the worst names. A name of a creature. And he did not find me a good mother. My mother wasn't righteous at all. And my father did not teach me one letter of the Quran. He was so disobedient. Umar radiallahu anhu, he told me you disobeyed your son before your son disobeyed you. To bring your children to the masjid to get education, to learn about Islam. Bring them to Sunday school to learn about Islam. The children will come to us at the age of 12, not young children. They have no idea about Islam. We ask them one simple question. How old was Rasulullah when he passed away? Hands go up, they say 1,000, 1,500, 2,000. They have no idea. The closest one was almost 1,000. None of them. How come? Lack of knowledge. So every time we teach about Islam, say, go home and teach your parents also. We get so happy when the young children learn Al-Fatiha correctly, the proper way. To learn about Islam in the public school, they're not going to teach them about the life of Umar, the seerah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the life of Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu. It's our job to teach our children. Whenever you pass away, whenever you die, your reward will continue. You'll be in the grave. And these rewards come into you. And you ask, oh Allah, what is these rewards from? From a righteous son. The righteous son, whenever he does a good deed, just like a copy machine, you get a copy and he gets a copy. This is your righteous son. Being obedient to your parents, my brothers and sisters, high status in paradise. Musa alayhi salam, asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ilahi, O Allah, man jalisi ma'i fil jannah? Who's going to be with me in Jannah? Close, sitting next to me in Jannah. With Musa alayhi salam. Then Jibreel alayhi salam descended and telling Musa alayhi salam, that man in that village, that's the one who's going to be with you in Jannah. So Musa alayhi salam went to monitor this man. What did he do so special to deserve to be with me, a companion in paradise? This man works hard all day. Nothing unusual. But whenever he goes home, Musa alayhi salam told him, I want to be your guest. He said, come on. This man, he goes in this cave. After a long, hard day. And beside, in this cave, an old woman. This man carries her just like a baby. Cleans her up. Wash her. Then he go cook for her. And he put the food in his mouth to chew it first. Then he put in the mouth of this old woman. Musa alayhi salam, he said, how long have you been doing this? He said, I've been doing this so many years. He said, who is this old woman? Man hahi al-ajuz? Qala hadhihi ummi. This is my mother. I have been taking care of her just like this status. She's so crippled. Cannot walk. Barely can talk. But she mumbles. She tells you a few words. He said, what kind of words she's saying? He said, every time I be kind to her, she always makes me this dua. She makes this dua that may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have my son with Musa alayhi salam. May him go in Jannah with Musa alayhi salam. He told him, I am the prophet of Allah Musa, and you shall be with me in Jannah, inshaAllah. Be kind and be righteous to the parents. Wallahi, no matter what you do, there is no way you can pay them back. Ibn Umar radiallahu anhu saw this man carrying this old woman on his back, making tawaf around the Kaaba. And he see Ibn Umar, he said, Ibn Umar, hal jazaytuha? This is my mother, this is her seat on my back. Did I fulfill her rights? Qala la, wala bi zafratin wahida. Not even one pain when she was delivering you. Qala Ibn Umar, inni ji'tu biha mashyan ala al-aqdam min bilad al-Yaman. Oh, Ibn Umar, I came all the way walking on my feet. This is her seat. Months and months traveling to make it to Mecca, make tawaf. وَحَمَلْتُهَا أَكْثَرْ مِمَّا حَمَلَتْنِي. And I have carried her more than she carried me in her stomach. قَالَ لَا وَلَا بِزَفْرَةٍ وَاحِدٍ. Because us, whenever you take care of your parents, you cannot wait, maybe you take care for a temporary time. Because you don't be back to your head, they're going to die one day. But whenever the mother and the father raise you when you're a baby, they want to see you as a man, strong, to take care of them. Just like they took care when you was a baby. Be obedient and be righteous to them. أقول قولي هذا فاستغفر الله وتوب إليه. الحمد لله الذي أمر بالبر والإحسان. والحمد لله الذي نهى عن العقوق وأذي الإنسان. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له. وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. Our subject today, my dear brothers and sisters, righteousness to the parents, بر الوالدين. من أفضل الأعمال إلى الله سبحانه وتعالى. Better than قراءة القرآن. Better than الصلاة النافلة. Better than all these نوافل after the fard, to obey your parents and be righteous to them. So what if our parents passed away? They still have a right on you. How? To make istighfar for them. To make a dua. To fulfill their promises. And to be righteous to them. And if they are alive, to take care of them. And be obedient to them. Because every one of us will have children. And you want them to